In this video, we're going to take a look at the socket outlets from BG that incorporate high-powered USB Type-C chargers. It probably hasn't escaped your notice that more and more devices are relying on USB Type-C connections for their charging. And this is only to be expected because this type of connector is now being rolled out as the standard USB connection. Even Apple have had to cave and move away from their proprietary connection. Rest assured, Steve Jobs would not approve. The Type-C connection has a number of advantages. Not least of these is that there is no right or wrong way round to make the connection between socket and plug, unlike the older Type-A connection. However, there are still an awful lot of devices, leads and connectors that rely on the Type-A connection, and we can be sure that they'll still be around for a long time to come. So BG have produced these lovely socket outlets that incorporate both a USB Type-A and a Type-C connection to charge and power your devices. At the time of shooting, they're available in the 900 white moulded range, which is the squarish fitting, the 800 white moulded range, which is the rounded edge accessory, and in the Nexus metal range in black nickel with black inserts, polished chrome with white inserts, and brushed steel with grey inserts, this last combination being my personal favourite. It's a great looking socket, and it's likely that these will be expanded into other finishes and ranges over time, so keep checking the product pages at BG for updates. In order to incorporate the USB chargers in the centre here, the switches have been located in the outboard position, meaning that they could help you to comply with certain elements of Part M. For further information on how to keep your wiring accessories compliant with Part M, please check out our free accredited CPD made in association with BG at the Luceco Academy online. Looking at the USB charger, you can see that you've got the Type-C on the top there and the Type-A below. Now, the additional advantage of these chargers is that they are 30 watts output, which is a decent size supply, and that can be split between the two charging outlets, with up to 4.2 amps being shared across the two ports. It's an intelligent charging point as well, in that it will auto-detect the USB device plugged in and then adjust the voltage and current that it delivers to suit the charging characteristics of the device. This means it can deliver 50% charge to mobile phones in just 30 minutes and charges 70% faster than standard 5-watt charging. It also supports the USB power delivery and Qualcomm quick charge protocols, which give you fast charging options across a vast range of devices. And as well, for those concerned with parasitic power or how much power the USB charging component in here is dissipating when it doesn't have a load connected, it actually has a standby mode for when it isn't charging, meaning that it uses less than 75 milliwatts of power when not in use, which is so small as to be negligible. To put it into context, I did some rough calculations, and it'll use about 2/3 of a kilowatt hour a year, maybe adding about 6p onto your annual electricity bill, depending on your tariff. So that's the customer-facing bit. What about the electrician's point of view? Well, with that power capacity that the socket has, you'd be forgiven for thinking that this socket has a back on it that would require a wide load sticker. And you may be worrying about the depth of the box required and the extra chopping in that it might need. However, it's remarkably shallow back here. BG have managed to incorporate the charging unit into here without adding much depth on the back at all. In fact, it will comfortably fit into a standard 25mm backbox, which is pretty remarkable. Again, for more information on the space requirements behind the socket outlet, please check out that free CPD at the online Luceco Academy. In addition to this, BG have clearly thought about the installer and have designed the socket with the terminals all in line and at the top of the socket to make the installation process quicker and easier. Also, those terminals are colour-coded with the conductor colours to allow positive and quick identification of the correct connections. There's also a really nice additional feature on here as well in the form of an additional earth terminal. So if you're installing this socket on a circuit that requires high integrity earthing, say for an IT room in a school or for office space, then you've got that extra earth terminal to allow for that. One CPC going into the top terminal and then the other going into the bottom one. Perfect. Another feature on here that I love that is so discreet it took me a little while before I noticed it, and that's this little plastic shield around the back here on the metal plate. Electricians of a certain age will remember the little pieces of loose plastic that used to come with decorative metal sockets and would be installed behind the accessory between the wall and the outlet. It was essential, but so often it used to kind of move and twist or kind of bunch up, meaning that the socket looked a bit weird against the wall. But this socket has that piece of plastic perfectly aligned with the edges of the accessory, meaning that you can barely see it once it's been installed. Of course, it's there to prevent moisture from a recently plastered and/or painted wall from coming into contact with the socket outlet and causing corrosion of the metal bodywork there. So I really like these USB sockets from BG. There's a style for every installation. There's a lot of thought gone into the design of it from the electrician's point of view, and I think they just look really smart. But as always, we want to hear from you. What do you think of these sockets from BG? Which is your favourite finish and insert combination? Will you be installing them in the near future? As always, please leave your thoughts and questions in the comments below. And as always, thank you very much for watching.